Hello everyone, it's Elena and I'm back with another video. And today I wanted to talk to you guys about how to prepare for law school. Now this is not one of these videos where I'll just be like, oh, print out your syllabus and, you know, get the books in your reading list. I'm pretty sure if you got into law school, you figured out that this is what you need to do. But here are five things that you can do right now over the summer break in order to put yourself in a better position once you start law school. But before we get into it, I want to introduce you to the sponsor of today's video, which is Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community with over 25,000 courses, and you can learn pretty much anything on there. So if there's something on your list of things that you want to learn and you just never really knew where to start learning it, Skillshare is probably the right place to do it. Skillshare has recently been helping me to make more use of my iPad Pro because I never really knew how to actually like draw some cool stuff on there, and they've really started to make me use that Apple Pencil a lot more when it's not for taking notes in university. Premium membership gives you unlimited access to all of their classes, and it's super affordable because it's less than $10 a month, and you can actually get 2 months of free premium membership with the link in the info box below, and then you can try it out, see if there's something on Skillshare that's for you, and I can promise you, there is so much to learn on there, you will definitely find a class for you. So yeah, I hope you guys will enjoy your 2 free months of premium membership with Skillshare, and now let's get into the video. Number one, read up on how to study the law. Because most students come to law school having never studied law before. So you need to read up on a few study techniques for this subject. There are a lot of great books out there that you can use in order to, you know, develop a few strategies that you can use once you're in law school, but you just need to read these books. And I'd highly recommend doing that over the summer break because over the summer break you still have the time to do it. And here are a few books that I personally would recommend. And I didn't read these over the summer break, instead I read them over the winter break because I learned the hard way that you need to read some of these books. So don't make the mistake that I made and instead read them now. So this is a book about just studying law, and it's quite general, but it has a few great techniques in it. And I would recommend it. It's not too expensive for, you know, a study book, so I think it's a good take for just, you know, a more general approach. And another thing that I'd recommend is how to write better law essays. And I think I would have benefited from reading this before I wrote my first law essay because it just gives you an idea of what law essays are supposed to be like. And it tells you what you're supposed to look out for, so you can ace your first essay, you know, by just reading this book, learning a couple examples of, you know, what your essay is supposed to look like. And I think it would have been really, really helpful for me. And of course, I have to recommend the Bible of every law student, Glanville Williams' Learning the Law. I think every law student in the UK has at least heard of this book if they don't have it on their shelf. And it is just a very useful overview. It explains a lot of things and, you know, tells you a couple of the things about law school, what you should look out for, etc. I think it's a great book, and you know, you don't need to read this entire thing. You can just skim it. This is for all of the books that I'm telling you about. You can skim them. You don't need to, you know, meticulously read every line, take notes on it, and whatever. They're just useful to, you know, get you in the headspace for studying law, and that's what they're really good for. Also, if you guys are interested in any of the books or anything else I'm going to mention in this video, I'll have it all linked in the info box below for you guys, so you don't need to worry about finding it again in this video. My second tip may sound a bit strange, but trust me, it will be helpful. Buy a dictionary. Now, I'm not talking about a normal language dictionary, unless you're an international student who needs it, like me. But I'm talking about a law-specific dictionary. So I got this Oxford Law Dictionary, and honestly, it has been so helpful. Because when you Google legal terms, Google gives you these Wikipedia definitions, which are just not reliable at all. And sometimes they don't even concern your jurisdiction. So please, don't trust Wikipedia on legal topics. It's usually not very trustworthy. So buy a dictionary instead. Trust me, it's worth your money. These have to undergo a lot more scrutiny than any Wikipedia page, so they are more reliable. And when you're reading through, you know, articles, judgments, whatever, and there's a term that you don't know, you can turn to this dictionary and it will tell you what this actually means, instead of a Wikipedia page, which may tell you something that's outdated or doesn't even apply to the UK. And your dictionary can come in handy when you're preparing for law school, because my next tip is to read up on current topics in the law. So you can do this by looking at different blogs, different websites, even some YouTube channels, and just figuring out, you know, okay, so what are some hot topics right now in law, especially in the subjects which you're going to study in your first year. I remember that when I tried to prepare, I didn't really know where to look, so I thought I'd give you guys a couple of resources that you can check out in order to get an idea of what current topics in the law are. So a blog that I'd highly recommend is Public Law for Everyone, and it's written by a professor from Cambridge, and it's really, really great, and it gives you a great idea of what current debates in constitutional law are, and I'd highly recommend reading through it. because it just gives you a great overview and it is really written for everyone. So you don't need to be a law student in your third year to understand what he's writing, and that's why I think it's so great, because it's very accessible but still very academic as well. And I think that's a great balance and a really, really good resource to look at. If you want to see more of, you know, the real life effects of legal decisions, you can just, you know, go to the BBC's Brexit section and take a look. Because the biggest topic in constitutional law right now is Brexit. And so much about the Brexit debate is actually connected to constitutional law, so that you have a pretty good chance, I'd say like a 95% chance, that a Brexit article is going to touch on a constitutional law topic. Once you've been through all of that, I would recommend trying to read a case. It will be hard and there will be a lot of things that you won't understand, but trust me, it will help you in the future, because when you have read a case for one time, then you at least know, okay, this is what a case structure looks like, this is, you know, how cases are written, because they're written very differently than normal writing. So just reading one of them, even though it's going to be hard and you may not understand everything, will help you in the long run. Now, when you haven't been to law school, you usually don't know where to get these judgments, but you can get them for free at Bailey or the Supreme Court page or a couple other pages. But I would highly recommend going to Bailey and checking out the Nettleship versus Western case. It's a tort law case. It's the first case that I ever read, and I think it's a case that's relatively accessible. It has a topic that, you know, everybody can relate to. It's important to everybody in society. So I think reading that case would be rather easy because you can understand the situation. And it's a case that is, I would say, interesting. If you guys want to read the case, I'll have it linked in the info box below for you guys and Bailey. And if you guys want to know how I read through cases, I made an entire video on my reading technique for case law, and you can find it linked in the info box below, and it's hopefully also going to pop up above my head somewhere right now. Hopefully. And while you read that case, make sure that you apply things that you learned from the books that you read. So make sure you look out for the ratio or for things that are just obiter. Make sure you really understand the case. And try to make a little note on that case. Just asking yourself, okay, what are the key facts from this case? What was the ratio? Was there any important obiter? Done. And when you can do that, you know you've understood the case. Once you've engaged with the case law and you know how to approach case law, you can then see how academics engage with case law and how they argue about it. And that's what I think makes these journal articles really special, because then you really see what a legal academic actually does and what they do with the court's work. Now, this is something you can probably only do at the end of your summer break, because you need university access in order to, you know, get access to these journal articles. But Cambridge, for example, usually sends the passwords out like a couple weeks before you come. So you can then go on Westlaw or really any other platform and get an article, read through it, you know, see if you understand it, see if you can understand the main argument, and, you know, if there's any interesting side things that you wanted to take a note of. And I think that's just a great way of preparing, because you are going to have to read a lot of journal articles, because law is not just about, you know, what the courts say the law is. It's also a lot about debate between academics, what it means, what the courts are saying, and also, you know, what are the gray zones where the courts haven't given a clear judgment yet. And that's why I think these journal articles are a great way of, you know, learning how you can engage with the law on a more academic level. If you're looking for a journal article that's relatively easy to read, in my opinion, even if you haven't studied a lot of law before, I'd recommend Raz's article on the rule of law. It's not, you know, a super easy article. Don't expect to read it and, you know, understand everything on the first read. But I think it's an article that's about a topic, the rule of law, which most people will know something about. And Raz addresses, you know, what people commonly think the rule of law is, and then he gives you his theory of what the rule of law actually is. So if you guys are interested in that article, I'm gonna have the full formal citation in the info box below for you guys, so that you can go and find it if you then want to read it. And yeah, those are my 5 tips for preparing for law school, and those are just things that I wish someone had told me a year ago. So I hope that I could help some of you guys. And if you guys are interested in my views on the law, I have a law revision channel where I talk about law, and I've recently taken a little break from it because I had some personal things that I went through, but I will be returning to this channel and to my website, elenamakessenseoflaw.com. So I'm gonna have these things linked in the info box below for you guys if you guys are interested in hearing more about me and the law, and basically just, you know, watching me being a little nerd. So yeah, I hope you guys found this video helpful. Thank you guys so much for watching. Have a nice day. Bye!